In the highlands, generally, people believe that, you know, certain people possess a power, you know, that has the potential to cause death or sickness of another person. People believe that sorcery exists, but we found out also that a lot of people believe in sorcery despite of the education level, despite of, you know, scientific explanations or biomedical explanations to sickness and death. People continue to hold on to the belief because I think it's deeply rooted. Normally, you know, violence is related to the belief because, you know, people believe that someone, you know, is possessed with an evil power to harm someone or cause sickness or cause death of someone. And so people retaliate, you know, when someone is sick or when someone dies.
Sorcery-related violence is a very big problem in Papua New Guinea. The form of violence that is caused is really inhuman treatment. Like, they torture you, they use burnt hands to put it on your skin, they chop you, even they kill you. So this is a real problem. Sorcery-related violence, it's a big issue in the highlands. It's a cultural norm. Most people are being accused and they are being tortured, and, you know, it's mostly the women, you know, they are targeted.
It's a belief that is so ingrained and so deeply rooted. We have received people, the hands has been cut off. They've been badly tortured with iron, with knives, with anything. When there is a death, they torture women, not men. The community is targeting the woman.
Especially in Chimbu and in the highlands where you talk about sorcery, it's like, it's the very immediate people that you trust and you rely on for security and for support that the very people will turn against you.
Hi, my name is Mary Kinney and I am from Papua New Guinea. I'm a human rights defender. I worked for Kupi Women for Peace for about 14 years.
Hi, my name is Monica Paulus and I'm from the Highlands Women's Human Rights Defender.
My name is Angela Apa. I am the coordinator for Kupi Women for Peace.
My name is Sister Gaudencia. I arrived in Papua New Guinea in 1969 and worked as a nurse midwife.
My name is Eriko Fufurefa and I represent Cafe Women's Association. We started in 2001 and so it's almost 13 years we operated.
My name is Gloria Rami. I am the human rights defender in the Southern Islands province. I am also the president of the Catholic Women's Organization of Catholic Diocese of Mendi.
I'm Philip Gibbs. I came to Papua New Guinea 41 years ago and I've been working as a priest here in different capacities.
My name is Lily Basher. I'm the leader for the organization West for Change.
I am Bishop Anton Ball, Catholic Diocese of Kundiawa. I am the one to organize programs to deal with this issue, sorcery and sorcery-related violence.
I'm Ume Wainit. I am the National Program Coordinator for Family and Sexual Violence in Papua New Guinea.
We came up with the idea of a rapid response team, and the idea of rapid response was like, it worked really well. We have district vocal people in the districts who quickly respond to these cases. Like if they hear a rumor that if someone is going to be locked up in a house and going to be burnt or tortured, they quickly call the network, call the police to go in, and we only give them the directions and the places where the women are. So they go into the village and they rescue them.
We
We are doing some great, great work, and I'm really pleased. I work in my own area, trying to prevent conflict, mainly to defend the rights of the people, those who have been accused of sorcery, was the target. But then we also do this program for eval, like ending violence against women as well. I see them, you know, when they approach us, they are in a terrible situation. When we help them out, they feel great. We see them, you know, coming out with a face where, you know, they are really, really happy. And when I see the happy face, I always feel satisfied.
And we go out in the communities to educate more of our youth and more of our people now, so that the people are aware of the new laws. We are now trying to educate more women to aware of where to go and get help, like we tell them where to report to. It is starting to move now because we have these human rights defenders in here, so we defend the rights of the women, and we go for advocacy programs like NGOs and churches and CBOs. We come together and we say no, do not harm women anymore. We don't want more women to be killed in our country.
It's about time that people have to speak up on what is not right. When we were doing the community consultation, they came up with a lot of way forward. They want to know the new law on sorcery, and support to community want to make changes. They want to make laws to stop people abusing each other. They also want ongoing training on the human rights, on ending gender-based violence. They ask for a rescue team to be set up.
The Catholic Church here in Papua New Guinea has taken quite a strong stance. I'm trying to be present to some people who have been hurt and really harmed, tortured, having been accused of witchcraft. I'm trying to run some workshops with in areas where people might be at risk. I also try to film workshops or film people who have got an opinion on this, so that we can circulate the opinions more widely. I can't be everywhere, but we can make lots of DVDs and then they can use them somewhere else. I always try to include questions. It's not a DVD for entertainment, it's a DVD as a discussion starter.
What my diocese is trying to do, to develop a strategy to look at the case and to convince people that this is a superficial belief. We are asking our people, our church leaders, people with respect, if that is happening in the community, they have to step in. We ask them to be part of the whole planning process. The immediate response is to take ownership of the situation, try to console them and give their dignity back.
It's difficult for people overseas when they see these headlines and think that everyone in Papua New Guinea is involved in this sort of thing, which is not true. And the majority of Papua New Guineans feel that this sort of thing is horrific. They would not want to take part in this sort of thing at all.
The women that in Papua New Guinea, they've got a tremendous strength. Despite of the kind of situation they are in, they have been able to move on in life if they are supported.
They trust me, that's why they come to me, so I have to try my best to find ways of helping and things like this.
When I do this work, I just dream and I just imagine how the women are safe. So I want more support for our women in the country.
time and we wonder why. Do what we can, laugh and we cry, and we sleep in your dust because we've seen this all before. Culture fades with tears and grace, leaving us stunned, hollow with shame. We have seen this all before.